and welcome to my kitchen. I'm Karen Whiting, author of many books, and today we're going to be making chicken pot pie. You can just make vegetable pot pie or beef, whatever you want to add into it. And as you see, the pot pie is just loaded and stuffed with all sorts of fresh goodies. And it's a great time of year to make them. You can freeze them. But right now, while we have so much fresh produce, instead of just using a package of frozen chopped vegetables, which you can do to make it quicker, you can use your fresh produce. So I'll take my corn, and I just, you know, cut that corn so that I get all the little kernels off of the cob. They want to just kind of pop all over the place on me today. But I will take those and I'll put them on my plate here. Now, I have different plates of vegetables today, and it's because they cook at different times. And really, since all of these can be eaten raw, they're perfectly fine that way. It doesn't matter how long you cook them, it's more personal taste. So I find that the carrots and the asparagus ends, I like to cook a little bit longer. And my green beans, you know, I can take them anyway, whether they've been cooked a really long time or a little bit, it's just fine. But I tend to put those in second after I've cooked up my chicken. First the chicken, and then, or potatoes if you're going to do that. And then I add in my carrots and my green beans, and then I'll add in asparagus tips and corn. And at that point I would also take some mushrooms and slice those up. I've already cleaned all my vegetables out and get them chopped up and add that in, because they don't really have to cook that long. And some things, you know, you might find that some of your family likes some of the vegetables and not all of them. So I cook down most of them in a separate pan, cook a few of the others. So my green pepper, since my son, who's on the other side of the camera, doesn't really care for peppers, I'll put that into some of the other pot pies, but not into his. And these vegetables are just wonderful to have. The peas I also put in towards the same time that I do my corn and mushrooms. So in order to get ready for this, I'm going to take our dough that we've been using all the time, the basic biscuit dough, and I'm going to take enough of that to roll out to do the bottom. And to do that, I'm going to roll my dough thin. And this is one that I cook this a little bit when I first do this, before I cook up this bottom dough, just like you would for a lot of pie crusts when you're making fruit and things without anything in it. So I take a plate, because this has depth to it, a couple inches really, and if I use this size plate, I find it's just about the right size to fill the inside of that. Take that up and make sure it's going to come up for me and not stick to my cutting my board there, or the surface that I'm doing this on. If it does, I would just roll it out again. But I tend to fold it in half and fold it in half again to have quarters, because then when I take my pie pan, I put that right in, right into this, the point into the center, and I unfold it. And when I do this, it fits just right. Otherwise, you lift that whole thing up and you might find you're halfway on and halfway off where you want to be for your pie crust. So at that point, I'm just going to press around and get it where I want it to be. And you can take a fork or a knife and cut off all the edges at the end. I just sometimes just break it off with my finger. But I now am going to take and prick with a knife or a fork all the way around the edge where the bottom meets the side, a little bit on the inside, a little bit on the sides. And that's so when I cook this, it won't puff up in places. It'll just stay very nice in the shell. And so this is one that's already cooked. And the next thing I do is I take my cooked vegetables and I start scooping them right in to my pie shell. And I just get these little individual pie shells, and I really like to scoop quite a bit into here. I like it to be nice and full, so you get a good serving size of it. Okay, and the other thing you can do, you don't, if somebody wants less carbs, maybe a little less calories, just don't put a crust in the bottom. And go ahead and fill that one up with your stuffing. And this is one that I'm going to be adding some peppers in, and they'll just cook right in while it's cooking in the oven, rather than having cooked that ahead. I could have sauteed them if I wanted to, but crunchy green pepper can be very nice. And again, we're just gonna fill this up quite a bit here. Have a nice pot pie for us. So now that I have these two that are filled, the next thing I wanna do is I wanna take some of this dough and I wanna make my upper crust, the top crust for that. So I'm gonna roll this out a bit. Now this, of course, doesn't have the depth, it has a little bit of height, so I wanna make it a little bit larger than the outside surface there. And I happen to have a plate that I like that's the sauce, a small dessert plate that I use to cut out this outside shape. And pull this dough away. So once I do that, again, I still like to take this in half, half again, so that I can put it on this crust. Let me bring this one over here. I'm gonna pull this in both directions. Now I have a nice crust sitting on top. I'm gonna go around here, and you can take a fork and put little prongs on it. You can take your thumb and put a little shaping all the way around, however you wanna do it. That helps seal it better so that that will stay and everything will be ready to cook. And then I poke four holes usually in my pie crust so that the steam can escape while it's cooking. And when I would put this into my oven, I usually put it on top of another pan, a cookie sheet or something, so that if it were to spill over at all, they usually don't, but if it were, then it has a place that it won't go to the bottom of your oven to make it dirty. It would just stay right on that other pan that you can clean off easily. So again, if I'm doing this one and it doesn't have the bottom crust, I'm going to make that maybe a little more dough for this one. So I'll just get that ready. Unroll this out. I'm going to talk and maybe even show you a little bit about how I do these fillings. And this one, you know what? It's just a little bit bigger than the plate. I think I'm going to use it as it is because I want to make sure I really cover the top of this one because there is no bottom surface. And I'm really going to almost pinch it over the edge all the way around here. So you see, sometimes I use the knife, sometimes I use my fingers. But that way, all right, let's slice that up. And again, this is just my basic biscuit dough that I use for so many things because I can cook that up and I can mix it up first, put that dough in my refrigerator and keep it for a week or more. It doesn't usually stay around my house much more than several or 4 or 5 days probably before I've used it for various things that I'm going to cook. So I have this crust on top, and again, I'm going to poke the four holes. When I get to my fork, I'm going to go around the edge and really use those prongs to make a pretty little edging like you see on this one here. Now, my basic dough, all you have to do is go to my website, KarenWhiting.com, Karen with a K, and sign up for my newsletter. And with the welcome newsletter, you will get the recipe to make the basic biscuit dough. It is a download, so you have to download it and then find it and open wherever you keep your downloads. Now, I want to talk a little bit about cooking these up. So let's go ahead and come over to my stove, put it on. I have already cooked my chicken, and I'm going to bring over some of my vegetables. So you can just keep that on this area. Okay. So here, I've cooked the chicken up. I've put a little bit of chicken broth in it. I'm going to put a little bit more in so that these vegetables will basically be still cooking there. And I will add in the carrots and the bottom of the asparagus first. So I'm going to cook those up for a couple of minutes. Just let them sit there cooking. And then it'll get hot enough for this. Just wipe flour off of my hands. One thing I wanted to mention is that besides loving bread and making things with bread. I also love to read about bread in the Bible. And one of the things that this today, when we have lots of pot pies, by the time I'm done, I'll have several of these made. And it just looks like an abundance. It reminds me in the Old Testament where God had his people make bread and put it on the altar every week. So in Leviticus 24, 5 to 8, it says, take the finest flour and bake 12 loaves of bread using 2/10 of an ephah for each loaf. Arrange them in 2 stacks, 6 in each stack, on the table of pure gold before the Lord. By each stack, put some pure incense as a memorial portion to represent the bread and to be a food offering presented to the Lord. This bread is to be set out before the Lord regularly, Sabbath after Sabbath, on behalf of the Israelites as a lasting covenant. So every week they would smell that bread baking in their large ovens. They'd see it on the altar. It would be brought in, and it was a reminder of the people that God used bread as part of the sign of the covenant between his people. That's what Jesus did too when he gave us the Eucharist, the communion, when he broke bread and said, this is my body. And so we have that sign, that significance in the Bible of what bread is for. But we also know when we see an abundance of bread, all these pot pies or biscuits or anything, we're reminded that that shows extravagant love when people are making abundance and sharing it with you and inviting them to your table, or you invite them to your table, and we just share and have fellowship with one another. What a great thing it is to do. Now, after I've started cooking the carrots and the asparagus for a little while, I add in my green beans and let them cook up. And about this point, some of these have popped out on me. I will add in a little bit of my gravy stock. And you can use packaged gravy, or you can make your own with some butter and that you melt on the stove, add flour and that in chicken stock that you have or you're working with. So all of this is going to just be cooking down for a little while. And after that cooks a little while, then I add in the rest of my vegetables. And so I'm just going to let them sit there, and we're going to come back over here and talk about pot pies again. So what I didn't mention now, when I cook the pot pie shell, the bottom layer, I put it in the oven at 400 degrees for just about 3 minutes or so. I'm not even necessarily getting it very brown. I just wanted to get partly cooked, because once all the vegetables are on, it would be very soggy if you didn't let it cook longer. And, you know, if you want to do a little bit longer, depending on how hard you want that bottom shell to be, you can keep it in 4 or 5 minutes even. And then when I have my pot pies ready, whether they have a bottom crust on them or they do not, you're just going to put them in the oven for about 12 minutes till you get the top of it a nice golden brown color, and it's all ready to pull out and serve nice and hot. If you want to freeze them, you can just take right like this, just in the dough, cover that up well with your saran wrap or put it in a plastic bag that ziplocks, and put it in your freezer till you're ready to bake them, at which point you're going to bake them for about half an hour or so. If you want to freeze it after you've cooked, maybe you've cooked plenty but there's some leftover after the meal, then just freeze that, and I might put it in my air fryer to heat up, or I might just put it back in the oven or my toaster oven and heat that for about 30 minutes. You just have to see when you think it's done. The pot pie that is raw dough is probably going to take about 5 or 10 minutes longer than when it's already cooked dough. So this could be anywhere from 20 to 40 minutes at 400, and this would I'd probably cook this one lower at 325 for about 30 minutes, and that's the difference there. But just enjoy. Go to your local farm market or your backyard if you have a garden. Choose the vegetables you want. You know, you can do zucchini and things. If you have zucchini, remember, it's going to have more liquid to it. You probably need less broth when you're cooking everything down. And just make whatever you want to in your pot pies, but enjoy them. So thanks for coming today.